All right, Shalom Amakiyam, first and foremost, I would like to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, HaKodesh. All right, double honors to the elders and apostles of our great millstone, who are the true elders and apostles over all Israel. All right, this is Brother Yahweh Sapp with another quick lesson. It's definitely not going to be too long tonight. I was thinking, you know, I've been having a lot on my mind lately about how the Lord's about to destroy this place and how everything in this place is failing. All right, the holidays are no longer the same. So-called holidays are no longer the same, man. People are not feeling that spirit anymore, and it's because it's dying off here, man. All right, the Lord is getting ready to raise up judgment against this place, and people are feeling more and more down by the day. And the only ones who are really getting in that spirit of excitingness or joyfulness are the men of the Lord, the 144,000 of the nation of Israel, which consists of you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, right? Those are the only people that are really getting excited, because we know we're at Esau's end, man. Esau, being the so-called white man, the red Hebrew Edomite, we know we're at his end. All right, and the Lord is getting ready to raise up a standard against this place to judge this place. All right, and that's something that we're wholeheartedly looking forward to. So with that being said, I want to go ahead and get it started. This is Isaiah 19 and 1. The burden, it's lucky I can read today. The burden of Egypt, behold, Yahweh rideth upon a swift cloud, and shall come into Egypt, and the idols of Egypt shall be moved out of his presence, and the heart of Egypt shall melt in the midst of it. That's right, and this isn't speaking about ancient Egypt, because that their judgment had already passed. So what Egypt is he speaking about? It's a spiritual Egypt, which is called Sodom and Gomorrah, which we know as America, okay, aka Babylon, the daughter of Babylon. All right, so it says verse 2, and I will set the Egyptians against the Egyptians, and they shall fight every one against his brother, and every one against his neighbor, city against city, and kingdom against kingdom. And we see that happening, man. You have you see a civil war brewing up here, man. Race wars is brewing up here, man. Martial law is brewing up here, man. All right, kingdom against kingdom. World War III is about to start. So we see all this boiling up to the point that this place is gonna fall. Okay, and it's a beautiful thing, man. People are getting mad over the stimulus check, which Esau's only giving you $1,200 to $2,000, or trying to. All right, and this place is failing, man. People aren't feeling the holiday spirit. All right, just as so-called New Year's. All right, people aren't feeling this place. All right, and this is the point I wanted to make. Verse 3, and the spirit of Egypt shall fail in the midst thereof, and I will destroy the counsel thereof, and they shall seek to the idols and to the charmers and to them that have familiar spirits and to the wizards, and the Egyptians will I give over into the hand of the cruel Lord, and a fierce king shall rule over them, saith Yahweh, the Lord of hosts. That's right, so the spirit of Egypt is failing. All right, and you see it, it's very evident, and if you can't see it, all right, at that point you're just doomed. All right, nobody's feeling the holiday spirit. Nobody's feeling anything, really. All right, there's a plague that came upon this place. All right, people they weren't excited to celebrate Thanksgiving. They skipped Easter. All right, they weren't excited to celebrate Halloween. All right, even last year, man, people weren't excited even before the pandemic. All right, so we know that this place is failing. All right, and it's a beautiful thing to see, because we know that after that comes what? The kingdom of Israel, all right, which is our kingdom, which shall last forever, and it's going to be peace upon the planet Earth. All right, so from there, all right, I want to go ahead and end it off on this, man. Like I said, it's going to be short. All right, this is going to be Isaiah 12 and 1. It said in Ecclesiastes 12 and 1, and it reads, remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in this, right? Remember thy creator in the days of thy youth, all right? Because this place is waxing old, all right? And you being young in the spirit, you're remembering the Lord, all right? Lord's will, you know, whoever watches this video knows Yahweh Bashem Yahshai. All right, so verse 2. While the sun or the light or the moon or the stars be not darkened, nor the clouds return after the rain. That's right. Remember the days of Yahweh. Remember the creator Yahweh whenever there's no affliction that comes upon this place, right, or upon you. All right. And I don't mean affliction like losing a car or house. I mean affliction like Esau breaking into your home, all right, taking you out, putting you in a FEMA camp. And that's the affliction we're talking about here. So it says, verse 3, in the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease because they are few, and those that look out of the windows be darkened. That's right. So remember thy creator before all of this happens, right? Because we see that this place is coming to an end, and this is about to happen. It's already been happening. Plenty of stores have closed down. Okay, they went bankrupt. All right, so the Lord is going to destroy this place, and it's already happening. All right, it's very gradual the way that it's happening. It's funny because we point out that Esau likes to be gradual in the things that he does, such as, you know, first the mask, now the vaccination, then it's going to be the mark of the beast, all through the spirit. That's what we're perceiving in our humble opinion. All right, the Lord does the same thing. You know, it's gradualism. First, so certain stores started closing down, then small businesses. Okay, now it's major companies that are about to close down. CEOs have been quitting all over the place, man. All right, so we know that the spirit of Egypt is failing. All right, so you must remember that creator, because if you don't, you're going to be thrust through. All right, so verse 4, Ecclesiastes 12 and 4, and the door shall be shut in the streets when the sound of the crying is low, and he shall rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of the music shall be brought low. That's right, there's going to be no more happiness in this place, man, and that's already happening as well. All right, so that we know that this place is about to be destroyed. We know everything's failing here, man. If you're feeling the spirit of this place, something's wrong with you. All right, I gotta say it how it is. Something's wrong with you. You're not right. Your spirit is not right. Okay, if you feel that nothing as bad is ever gonna happen here, then you know you're gonna be thrust through. All right, the men of the Lord know that this place is going to be destroyed. Even everyday people know that this place is going to be destroyed, man. You have them talking about it, so-called woke people, or even average everyday people. You look on the comment boards of the videos of the news. Okay, you know that this place is failing. All right. And that's a beautiful thing to come unto our people and unto our nation. All right. And unto the earth and the whole world, the galaxies. All right. So with that being said, man, I don't want to make this too long. I want to get Lord's will. The session was edifying, and I want to give all praises, honor, and glory once again unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahushai, Bahashem, Kakudash. All right, double honors to the elders and apostles of a great millstone, who are the true elders and apostles of all Israel. All right, till the next time I say, Shalom.